and I'm just like working. I used to have my desk here. It was glass, and you know, one unfortunate turn, it someone grabbed it and it went crashing down. Mm. But yeah, this is
it's part of the risk of living with the reality of it all.
A friend of mine did that piece. It's about gentrification and death side. He did this almost 10 years ago. Wow. Yeah, I think it was 2013. Actually, he may have done this in 2012. Yeah, so it's a, you know, it's about death side and gentrification. And now this, it is, it is no longer a threat. It is
reality.
Reality. Yeah. So. But yeah, it's just comfort. That's what I. That's what I. Wow. Do. That's what I go for. I just.
I thought you were beyond me, man.
Well, wait until we open books like you were letting me open, and actually my art. So. I will show you like where I, as I'm scrambling to get this together, mm-hmm. I had to take all of them. I took a good portion of my art that's in my collection down, but it's all in that room.
I see. I saw that. Yeah.
Or most of it is in that room. Some of it, it's layered under. I'm just like, okay, because I don't have my system. My system yet.
I know. So. And it's good to sometimes have some of that discreet, at least for my little videotaping purpose. It's good to have some of your stuff, not so, now we know what he's got in his house. We can come get it. Or we can now covet it even more.
So,
I appreciate you letting me, because this is beautiful and you talking about it. Have you done this before? To walk people through your home and talk about it?
My place has been, have I been on? I may have, because people a lot, but because I'm so fascinated with your space. Mm-hmm. When Shay took me to your space, and Shay was like, oh no, you just have to see his space, you have to see. And the freedom that you allowed me in your space, mm-hmm. like you, I'm going through everything, you allowed me to try on some items of clothing you had, so it is me reciprocating. And it's easy because I talk again. There's a project that I had in my head for a while that I'm going to activate in short order, and you and your space is part of it. Mm. What I'm doing is I'm going to show Black men in their homes around the globe.
Mm.
Yeah. Because I've gone into some spaces that have made my head spin, and also to remove the idea that you're talking about, like, oh, the ones that are in the shelter magazines, the Architectural mm-hmm. Digest, the Home Decor, whatever, and some a good number of those spaces wouldn't make it into those things, mm-hmm. but they are not but, and they are wildly amazing spaces. Wildly amazing spaces. I go to you may meet some new people, and then when you're in their space, the way Black men. And some they're just in, they may be in just very sparse spaces, but their possessions or their uniforms. I am fascinated with the way Black men display their baseball caps mm. in some spaces. There's just this whole display thing that goes mm. on in addition to cologne.
Mm. So
they do it with baseball caps, cologne. And some even with empty liquor bottles. Mm-hmm. And it's just, they keep them in the way these collections are, the way they opt to show these collections, I think fascinating. Mm-hmm. One of the funniest things, I'll tell you, I'm met someone on one of the apps, was in his space, and I was, but he was a beautiful man. His space was fascinating. Fascinating. He didn't think it was fascinating at all. Actually, no, he did. He put a lot of work into it. It was fascinating the way that he had painted the entire place black. Mm-hmm. The entire place black. He covered all of the windows with light blocking shades. And then he painted himself. He just painted some markings on the walls with glow in the dark paint. Mm-hmm. So it was, you know, the garish pink, that garish yellow and the green. And then he also had glow in the dark posters. In addition to that, you know, the blankets that they have at the 99-cent store, the furry ones.
Yeah.
So those were the blankets that were covering his bed and the sofa, and then he had a bunch of the stuffed toys from Coney Island. Mm-hmm. A bunch of them. So he had so that was it. So, and he turned on, you know, it was pitch black, and he had on whatever the light was. It allowed the things that glowed in the dark to
like a translucent.
It would have this fluorescent.
Fluorescent, that's the word. Yeah.
And then he had lava lamps, where the things. It was fascinating. I tell you, and I'm not joking, I walked out and I called a magazine editor. I'm like, you must see this space. Uh-huh. I'm like, I don't know if I could get back in. I was like, but I'm going to describe it to you, and it should be on the cover of some magazine, because it was fascinating, just cheap shit.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was fascinating. I'm like, this is brilliant. It was even his carpet. Was this carpet black? I don't know if the carpet may have been a dark brown, or maybe the regular sort of oatmeal, no pile carpets that are on the. It was fascinating. I almost want to say that the walls, he had hung the furry blankets on the walls in the bathroom also. So everything, but it was just this tactile thing. And he didn't process it as anything special. It was just that, oh, this is what I wanted to do. I'm like, this is special.
Yeah.
This is special. Now, he never let me back in, so the magazine editor was never able to see it, but it was fascinating. And I, you know, you go and you see, you know, it's like, oh wow, like baseball caps and shoes, sneakers, they're lined, and I'm like, they are perfectly straight. And it's just rows and rows of them. They'll have, I don't know, maybe 100 baseball caps. I'm like, do you wear these? Oh yeah, you know, I could see them. I'm like, wow, you know, and then the shoes and whatever. And then everything else is like bare bones. Some, you know, beat up sofa, some, you know, broken chair and whatever. But I'm just like, these spaces are fascinating, you know?
And it's so interesting when you describe that young man's space. In my head, I could see some people walking going, this is tacky.
Exactly.
Right?
Most people would take it. I'm like, this, it was brilliant. To me, I wish I knew somebody at World of Interiors. Mm-hmm. It was the type of space that World of Interiors would absolutely relish. Mm-hmm. It was fantastic, because it reminded me of the quirky European spaces, or how they do actually in parts of South America and the Caribbean and in Africa, where it's just, we're gonna just use what we have. And then the spaces are like mind blowing. You're like, what? Mm-hmm. You've taken labels and you've made wallpaper from cereal boxes? You've taken, you know, cans, and you have enough cans to fill this entire wall? this is amazing. And it speaks about love of place. This is my place. This is what I love. And that's all he saw. Oh, this is what I don't. He didn't care if anyone else thought it was special. And he actually thought most people wouldn't find it special. Mm-hmm. It was. I still think about that space. And I saw that space at least 15 years ago, if not 17 years ago. And I still see it.
And
it is
even the way you described it, almost to the detail.
It is seared, and because it was amazing. I was like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And he was like, oh, whatever. I was like, what?
And it probably has inspired you a little bit over the years, even just how you think about approach to something, right?
Or projects. Absolutely. Yeah. And that's the thing, folks are like, oh, you can't. I'm like, no, that taught me something. Mm-hmm. That taught me something, because it was all encompassing. It was. Mm-hmm. He went all in. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And it was fascinating. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my gosh. It was fascinating. It was fascinating. Because first he opened the door, it was dark. I'm like, can you turn on the light? You know. But it was. Oh my gosh. I wish people could have seen that space. It was fascinating. It was fascinating. And that White magazine editor, she wanted to see the space. She's like, well, if you're telling me about it, I need to see it. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I'll get in. I don't know if he'll respond, but it didn't happen. But yeah, it was fascinating. Other thing, I love plants. I want to live in a jungle.
I'm seeing.
I want to live in a jungle.
Everywhere. What do you mean you live in a jungle? Plants outside, you know, everywhere we've gone in the bathroom. That's why I asked this is a bathroom you use. You're like,
yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. So, because as much as I love interior, mm-hmm. and as much as I love art, they're both work, and there are stresses that come with it. And there is no point where I ever want to feel stressed. And I find comfort in plants. I find comfort in art. And I find comfort in water. Mm. That's, you give me art, plants, and water?
Life.
Absolute life, period.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Wow.
So,